So, hi all, like I'm start recording the session. Yesterday, we are successfully created master data. Like what type of master data? Customer master data and material master data and create condition type. So these three things we successfully created. Now, we want to post document entries. So guys, can you please note it down one note? Initial stock uploading. And O2C, order to cash. Initial stock uploading and O2C, order to cash. Accounting entries generated automatically. For that purpose, we assign the GLs T code, VKOA and OBYC. Example, note it down. Example, COGS, cost of goods sold account, we assigned in OBYC. Next line, sales revenue GL account, we assigned in VKOA T code. Can anyone read once what things you noted?
Initial stock uploading and O2C, order to cash, accounting entries generated automatically. For that purpose, we assigned the GLs T code, VKOA and OBYC. Example, COGS, we assigned in OBYC. Sales revenue GL account, we assigned in VKOA.
Okay. Yeah. Guys, yeah. Now, first initial stock uploading. And after initial stock uploading, post O2C, order to cash. Guys, concentrate here. Initial stock uploading. What is the T code for initial stock uploading? MB1C. To post initial stock uploading, MB1C. T code is called MB1C. So what is the accounting entry? Finished goods, nothing but inventory. Finished goods account data to initial stock uploading clearing account. Okay. For example, at the time of initial stock uploading, inventory account data to initial stock uploading clearing account. Now, at the time of outbound delivery, means material sent to the customer. That time, COGS account data to inventory. See here. At the time of outbound delivery, means material sent to the customer, that time inventory is credit. Initial stock uploading, inventory is debit. So debit and credit must going to clear. finished goods nothing but inventory guys. Initial stock uploading inventory is an debit. At the time of outbound delivery means material sent to the customer, that time inventory is credit. So debit and credit going to nullified. Okay, so now let's do that. Let's assign initial stock uploading. Let's post initial stock uploading clearing account. So where and how we can, let's do that. Go to MB1C, then let's open SAP. I'm trying to open SAP. Then enter username and password. It's going on browse guys, please wait 2 minutes. It's going on browse. Yeah, now guys, try to understand MB1C, initial stock uploading clearing, initial stock upload. Okay, yeah, let's go to MB1C, press enter button in the keyboard. And guys, document date and posting date. For your understanding purpose, let's this document post in yesterday date, 31st 12 2021, and give it here any slip number, material slip number, example HM-001. If you want to write the narration, you can write it here, example being stock upload. And the GRIR slip number means if you see the physical document, there is one number, example HMFG. You can set up, enter any up to four digit. It may be numerical or it may be alphabets guys. Now here, movement type. At the time of initial stock uploading, movement type is 561. 561 is the standard movement type for initial stock uploading. Now, what is your plant? Our plant is HMPT. Then what is your storage location? Storage location is HMFG, I believe, right? Storage location HMFG means finished goods storage location. This is my plant and this is movement type 561. It is a standard movement type for the initial stock uploading. Okay, now press enter button in the keyboard. Then enter your material. So what is our material guys? HM steel. Then how much quantity? Example 1000 quantity. Then press enter and click on your post. Guys, last class I gave one note. Note it down once again. At the time of initial stock uploading, everyone please note it down one note. At the time of initial stock uploading, we are unable to specify the price, comma price will be picked from material master data. Price will be picked from material master data. Price will be picked from material master data. Anyone read once?
At the time of initial stock uploading, we are unable to specify the price. Price will be picked from material master data.
Very good. This is the important point actually. Okay. So enter your material and quantity. Press enter button in the keyboard. Enter. It's going on browse. Yeah. Then click on your post. It's going on browse. Why? Because you know we are first time in the SD. We are first time posting initial stock uploading, right? So it is searching all the data. It is fetching all the data, all your configuration. See this one, document has been posted. So how I can see this accounting entry? Go to and other goods receipt, click on your display. And press enter button in the keyboard. And click on your, see this one, accounting document. See this one, guys. Finished goods account data to initial stock uploading. This is the accounting entry. So accounting entry reflected automatically. Guys, for your understanding purpose, I can post once again. To initial stock uploading, listen carefully. Okay, go to MB1C to post initial stock uploading. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then as usual, enter your document date, posting date, whatever date you want. HM02 now, second document. And here being stock uploading and HMFG movement type, standard movement type 561. And our plant and storage location. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then what is your material and how much quantity? Example, my quantity is 3000 kgs. Then press enter button in the keyboard. Click on your post. Very simple, guys. The accounting entry reflected automatically. For that purpose, we mapped the GLs. Okay. And go to document and display and press enter and accounting entry. Yeah. Now note it down. One more. Now our target is to post O2C. Order to cash. First, sales order. If you post sales order, no accounting entry will involved or no accounting entry will generated. And post outbound delivery, post outbound delivery and post goods issue, VL01N and VL02N, outbound delivery and post goods issue. Okay, so what is the accounting entry? COGS account data to inventory. And post sales invoice, post sales invoice, what is the accounting entry? Customer account data to sales revenue. And post customer payment, what is the T code? What is the T code? F-28 or, and you can use even F110 also. Okay, you can use F110 also for customer payment. Mostly cash or bank account data to customer. Guys, this is the mandatory interview question. If you attend any interview, 99% of interviewer can ask the question, what is the P2P and what is the O2C? If they ask P2P, then you can say MM accounting entries, procure to pay accounting entries. If they say O2C, then you can say this accounting entries. If they ask initial stock uploading, you can say this accounting entries, this accounting entry. O2C is the mandatory interview question. What is the accounting entries? Then you can immediately, you want to say this answer. Okay, very, very important. Okay, even last time, Vandana also posted some interview questions na yesterday. There also, I believe this question. Yeah. Okay. Yes, guys. Now, I want to post sales order. Sales order. Note it down, guys. Note it down. Do one thing. Note it down. VA01. Post sales order. And VA02. Change or edit sales order. And VA03, display sales order. Note it down, guys. VA01, post sales order. VA02, change sales order. And VA03, display sales order. Display sales order. Done, everyone?
Done.
Yes, yeah. Yes, sir.
Let's post sales order VA01. Let's post sales order VA01. Sales order. Go to VA01, VA01, press enter button in the keyboard. Guys, be careful. Press enter button in the keyboard. And order type. Guys, I will tell you one thing. Please keep it on your mind. Here at the time of O2C, major things involved SD consultant. So our part is to test, and our as a FICO consultant, our part is to test accounting entries reflected automatically or not. If it is not reflected, let's check GL creation and let's check GL mapping, OBYC and VKOA. If you are successfully created your GL, if you are successfully mapped or assigned your GL, then accounting entry will reflected automatically. Remaining things take care by the SD consultant. Okay? Yeah. And order type. And this is the order type, guys. OR. OR is the standard order. OR is the standard order. Click on your browse. Click on your browse. Order type is OR, standard OR, standard order, whatever. OR. Yeah, where is that? OR. OR. Yeah. OR means standard order. Standard order. Double click on OR. Now, sales organization. Can anyone tell me what is our sales organization? Can anyone?
HMSO.
HMSO. And distribution channel. Anyone?
HW.
Wholesaler. Very good. And division. HS. Very good. And press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter button in the keyboard. And sold to party, shipped to party. Sold to party, shipped to party, nothing but customer. Here you can take the customer. Click on your browse. And customer. What is our customer? 12SD Private Limited. Yeah, 12SD Private Limited. And customer. And here. Required date, let's take yesterday data, 31st 12 2021, why new year. Yeah, our plant HMPT, then here you can write the description if you want, being whatever. And now here material, what is the material? HM steel. How much quantity? Example 250 quantity. And use tap, use tap, use tap. Here, enter here, plant, HMPT. And guys, see this one, net price. Hurry, where it is? Here, net price in display mode. Why? Now I can ask one question. Yesterday I gave one note.
It's picked up from the material.
Based on condition type.
Based on condition type. Very good. For O2C accounting, postings, price will be picked from the condition type. Okay? And press enter button in the keyboard. Guys, press enter button in the keyboard. Enter again. Enter. And enter, you just double click on this line item, guys. You just double click on this line item and click on your schedule line. See here system will suggest when the material was going to delivery. So your outbound delivery means your material outbound delivery sent to the customer to material on this date, guys. Okay, and here account assignment, what is your business area, what is your profit center, here some details will be going to display. Yeah, here shipping, some, what is your plant, what is your shipping point, some things will be allowed here. Okay, then click on your post or save, whatever. it is fetching all the data, it is checking all your configuration if you post in first time. Okay, if everything is good, then document can be going to save. Okay, what is that? What is the sales order number? 14404. 14404. Please keep it on your mind. 14404. Now, guys, let's try to understand here. Next one. Outbound delivery. Next one. Outbound delivery. Okay. Now, here, outbound delivery. Go to VL0VL01N. VL01N. Press enter button in the keyboard. So, shipping point. What is our shipping point? HMSP. What is our shipping point? HMSP. And selected date here, material delivery date. So, in the sales order, whatever material delivery date is there, same date you want to take here. Example 03/1/2021. And this is the sales order number. And press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter button in the keyboard. And as usual, you can check all the data come from the sales order. So you need not to enter anything here. All the data picked from the sales order. So you can check everything, whatever it's correct or not. In case, for example, my sales order is 250 quantity, but I am delivering the goods only 200. So you can change the quantity. For example, my sales order is 1000 quantity, but I am delivering the goods only 500. So here you can change. Here you can change if you want. Okay. Then use tap, tap, tap. Use tap, tap, tap. You can check all the details. And picking quantity. Example here also 250. Okay. And use tap, tap, tap. Use tap. You can check all the details. Here storage location. Don't forget here to storage location. What is our storage location, guys? HMFG. HMFG. From that storage location, we are delivering the goods. Okay. And picking. Let's check the picking. And here also, let's check the all the things. Quantity, delivery quantity, and picking quantity, whatever. And press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter button in the keyboard and click on your save. This one. Delivery document number has been saved. Delivery document number has saved. Now, let's take this number. What is the number? 800017183. Please keep it on your mind. 800017183. 800017183. Let's do the copy. Now, guys, now what can I do? Post goods issue here. Post goods issue. Post goods issue. VL02N. Here, in the post goods issue, accounting entry will going to generate. Here in the post goods issue, accounting entry going to generate. Until that means, if you send material to the customer, then only accounting entry will going to generate. Otherwise, accounting entry, if you post sales order in outbound delivery, accounting entry cannot generate it. So go to VL02N, VL02N slash and go back VL02N. Press enter button in the keyboard. Is this correct? 800017183.
Yes.
And press enter. If you press enter, everything will come. Change outbound delivery. Everything come. In case if you want to change anything, otherwise keep it as it is. Click on your post goods issue here. Post goods issue. this one. Delivery 80017183 has been saved. Sir, now how I can see the accounting entry? Now I can see how I can see the accounting entry. Guys, let's try to understand here. Go to environment. Click on your document flow. Go to environment and click on your document flow. Otherwise, here, simply click on your this radio button, guys. Document flow. Are you able to see my screen? This is also document flow. Either click on your this or go to environment, click on your document flow. Click on here. Yeah, now see here, all the details it going to displayed. We are successfully posted sales order. We are successfully doing delivery, picking request, post goods issue. Everything is going success. In case if it is any error, just throw out the error here. Okay, please check the flow. So how I can see that? So select here goods issue, post goods issue, select this, click on your display document and accounting document. So what is the accounting entry, guys? COGS accounting data to finished goods. COGS 81 means debit, 99 means credit. COGS accounting data to finished goods. Finished goods nothing but inventory. Okay, I'm repeating once again. How I can see the accounting entry? Let's go to VL02N. Enter here. Either you can click on document flow or either you can go to environment or document flow. Both are same. Document flow and select here post goods issue and click on your display document and click on your accounting document. This is the one. Now our final target is to post invoice. Everyone knows, right, how to post customer payment, F-28. Okay, now post sales invoice VF01. Take VF01 and go to VF01, press enter button in the keyboard. And you can enter here that outbound delivery number 80017183 and press enter button in the keyboard. All the data pick from there. So you are not required to enter anything here. All the data pick from picking request. Whatever document you posted now, from all the data, all the inputs pick from there. Simply you can click on your post. This one document has been posted. Sir, how I can see the accounting entry? Very simple, guys. Go to billing document and display and click on your accounting flow or otherwise here document flow, display document flow or accounting. Let's click on your document flow. And select your invoice accounting document. Select your invoice accounting document and display document. This is the one. Customer account data to sales revenue. This is the accounting entry. How I can see that? Let's listen careful. So this is the here you can enter billing document number and click on your document flow, display document flow. Select your last one, accounting document. Select display document. Display document. And OK. This is the one. And you know very well, right? How to post customer payment. Note it down one note, guys. Majorly, what type of issues will come at the time of document entry postings? Note it down. What type of issues will come